I'm Jesse Barber, and I'm an assistant professor in the Department of Biological Sciences, and we're here in my lab. This is the flight room where we film bats and moths hunting and ask questions about the strategies they use to avoid echolocating bats. And in this work, we've made a couple of really cool discoveries in the last 2 years. The first one is that we discovered that hawk moths jam bat sonar, and they use modified structures at the tip of the abdomen, at the end of the moth, as the bat's approaching the rear end. They blast sound out and jam their ability to localize with sonar. And that's evolved at least twice in this group, and probably more times. And the second discovery we've recently made is that the long tails of Luna moths, this whole family of moths has many species with long tails. They spin behind the moth and attract the bat's attention. And the bat grabs this expendable appendage and the moth gets away. And this affords an almost 50% survival advantage to the moths, which is the same as been quantified for bat detecting ears, another common anti-bat strategy. I think one of the more unique things about these kinds of questions is that they're describing the natural world around us. At its heart, we're simply natural historians. We're detailing how the world works, which might at first thought not have any tangible influence on our lives. But I would argue that science for science's sake has created untold number of applications, but maybe more importantly, I personally feel somewhat of an obligation to describe these patterns, because we're in a golden age of biology. We are maybe the last generation or two that has a chance to tell these stories across the tree of life that's unfolded, because species extinctions are happening so fast that we have this narrow window to understand all of these transitions.